so I feel like if you're watching this, you probably already know that basically, like, everyone like that's in college across the nation has had to leave because of coronavirus. But there are a couple of campuses that have allowed a small number of students to stay on campus just for a wide number of reasons. Things are a lot different at Stanford. It's just really weird being, like, one of the few people on campus, and, like, you can walk around and you won't really be seeing a lot of other people. Around, like, 600 students have remained on Stanford's campus. You're not really allowed to leave our rooms unless it's to go eat or go exercise outside. I feel like not a lot of people truly understand, like, how different it is, so I kind of just wanted to show you, like, a day in the life of what it's like to be quarantined on campus.
All right, so I have two classes today. I'm just walking to breakfast right now to the dining hall because I have to pick it up and bring it back to my room. Something that's new is that we're not allowed to eat in the dining halls anymore. Everything is prepackaged. You have to wear a face mask and wash your hands when you get into the dining hall. I'll try film and see if I can do that, but I just have to pick up the food, go to my room, and then I have class soon, and then I'll take you guys along on that.
So I really tried when I was at the Post to do stories about the Palestinians. So one of the stories I sent you maybe, or I didn't, was about the beach days. Like,
yeah, it's a set of animation and it's like, it's not exactly like a flashback, but it's like a, yeah, certain out of time experience. Particular, but like the ones that you did are like, makes me yearn for, like, because I mean, they look like Animal House and the Breakfast Club.
Okay, so hopefully this is working because I'm just gonna do this in one take. I'm in 6 classes this quarter, definitely should not have enrolled in that many, but here we are. But in terms of my actual learning experience for those classes, it hasn't been as bad as I thought it would be. I think that has to do with the fact that, like, half of my classes are seminar based and there's less than 15 people in each of those classes. So it's been great because I've been able to, like, participate and, like, really engage in the material as well as with the students and the professors of those classes. But I also am in 2 lecture based classes, and for those classes, have not been to lecture since week 5, if I'm being completely honest. I really haven't been able to focus in those classes, and I'm not able to, like, retain the information the way that it's taught. My style of learning is not really conducive to, like, watching pre-recorded videos. So for those classes, not sure if I'm gonna pass or not, but honestly, at this point, like, I just wanna finish the class. Given the fact that professors also had to adapt to an online system basically, like, over the span of a week or 2 weeks, like, I can't really blame them for anything in terms of the quality of their teaching over Zoom, just because there's a lot of factors that are not in their control. I still prefer an in-person class as opposed to an online class, just because I think the beauty of coming to college, and whether it's Stanford or any other college, where you're having classes in person, is that you can have very meaningful interactions with the students in the class, as well as with the professors, through participation and, like, face-to-face interaction, and it's really hard to replicate that through Zoom and online learning. It's still kind of awkward sometimes. Like, there's going to be moments where people are trying to speak over each other. Like, sometimes there's Wi-Fi and internet issues. I don't really want to complain about the quality of teaching and even just, like, the quality of the education that I have right now, because I understand that I'm very privileged to, one, be able to attend Stanford, and then also I'm very privileged as well to have been able to stay on campus where I have a Wi-Fi connection, I have a place to sleep at night, I have food to eat. So I think, like, in the macro scheme, I don't wanna, like, make my problem seem like they're the worst in the world, just because they aren't. We're in a literal pandemic and people are literally dying. So I don't really want to downplay that because that's a shitty thing to do. But I miss having classes in person and then a lot of the other things that come with an in-person experience of college. Also, something else is that there's like little study spots in this laundry room. They built a bunch of white tents. I'm pretty sure it's for COVID testing, but I haven't seen anyone use it yet. So after dinner, I ended up taking a quick shower just because I was still really sweaty from my workout and it was just really hot. But after that, I ended up taking a walk around campus, which is actually something I've been doing every single day ever since Corona hit and we've been in quarantine. The sun sets pretty late now, like around 8:30-ish, so it's really nice to kind of just get some fresh air and watch the sunset before going back to the dorm and getting some extra work done before I end my night. But that's what I'm doing right now. Usually there are so many people here at sunset, but there's like literally no one. This is so weird. Now the lights turned on. Just me, but I feel like being quarantined has made me reflect a lot and has almost put me through this psychological puberty, if that makes sense. I feel like I'm a lot more in tune with myself just because I've had a lot of time to reflect on my college experience and like what I hope to achieve before graduating. This is gonna sound really like fake deep, but I feel like something that I'm gonna take away from this experience is that I should live without regrets. I mean, like, no one could have predicted a literal pandemic, but here we are. Anyways, I'm doing this voiceover at 4 a.m., so maybe that's why I sound like a bootleg motivational speaker who thinks that he's doing something, but I think it made sense. So I'm editing the video right now, and it is literally 4:33 a.m., and I have class in less than 4 hours, so... anyway... This is gonna be like a quick nerdy side note, but something that I learned in my research for this project is that the post office is actually like the number one rated government agency in the US, which is like super interesting. Okay, so honestly, it's so hot in here that I literally cannot focus. So I think I'm just gonna stop for tonight and I'll just wake up early tomorrow and try to finish before class. But yeah, I guess that is the end to my day. Thank you.